The FlowQuick Wizard is the fastest and easiest way to program a simple flow measurement application. Power up the device and press the right arrow to enter the main menu. Press the right arrow again to select the Wizard's option. Press the right arrow to select Quick Start. Highlight QS Flow and press the right arrow to select, followed by the down arrow to select Start. If you have a dual point version, press the right arrow to select Edit to choose your measuring point. Using the up and down arrows, select what point you are programming and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to select Next to proceed. To select your transducer model, press the right arrow to edit. The factory default is No Transducer. Select your transducer model and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to select Next to proceed. As the speed of the sound changes with temperature, it's critical that we know the ambient temperature in the process to achieve an accurate measurement. Now, let's select your temperature source by pressing the right arrow to edit. In open channel flow applications where high accuracy is required, the optional TS3 sensor is recommended. Highlight your temperature source and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. Now, let's select your units of measure. Press the right arrow to edit. The units you select will be used for setting your measurement range and the calibration points and be displayed on the screen when in run mode. Highlight your units of measure and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. The next step in the wizard is to enter the empty distance. The empty distance is the distance from the face of the transducer to the process empty point of the primary measuring device. Press the right arrow to edit the empty distance value. Use the left and right arrows to move the cursor and up and down arrows to modify the empty distance value. To move the decimal point, position the cursor over the decimal point, and then use the up arrow to move it to the left and the down arrow to move it to the right. Once you have put in your empty distance, press the right arrow to highlight OK. Press right again to accept the empty distance value. Press the down arrow to proceed. Next, let's enter the span distance. Press the right arrow to edit. The span is the measurement range from the primary measuring device empty point. The span should match the max head dimension of the PMD structure. Remember that the transducer should be mounted a minimum distance of 0.3 meters above the max head to allow for the blanking dimension of the transducer. Set your span distance value using the up and down arrows. Once the span distance value has been entered, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted. Press the right arrow again to accept. Press the down arrow to proceed. The next step is to set the reaction speed of the device. The factory response rate default is set to medium, which is a rate of level change less than 1 meter in 1 minute. Press the right arrow to edit. There are three options for speed of response: slow, medium, and fast. Your response rate should be set slightly higher than the maximum process response change. Highlight your response rate and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. The next step is to select the primary measuring device. Press the right arrow to modify this value. An open channel flow installation is defined based on the primary measuring device. In our example, select exponential devices and press the right arrow to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. The flow exponent value is provided by the manufacturer of the primary measuring device. Press the right arrow to edit. Set your exponent value using the up and down arrows. Once you have input the exponent value, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted and press the right arrow again to save your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. The maximum head value represents the highest head level supported by the primary measuring device. This dimension should correspond to the span dimension previously entered. Press the right arrow to edit. Set your maximum head value using the up and down arrows. Once you have input the maximum head value, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted, and press the right arrow again to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. The next step to enter is the zero head. The zero head value is entered when the zero reference is at a higher elevation than the channel bottom. Press the right arrow to edit. Set your zero head value using the up and down arrows. Once you have input the zero head value, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted, and press the right arrow again to select. The next step is to enter the maximum flow. Press the right arrow to select Edit to modify this value. The maximum flow represents the flow at maximum head and is used to define the highest point in the exponential curve. Set your maximum flow value using the up and down arrows. Once you have input the maximum flow value, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted, and press the right arrow again to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to proceed. Now, let's enter the flow rate decimal places required. Press the right arrow to modify this value. Use the up and down arrows to select the required decimal places and press the right arrow to select. Press the down arrow to select next to proceed. The next step is to enter the number of flow time units. The flow time units is used to display current flow and logging flow values. Press right to edit. Select the required flow time units and press right arrow to select. Press the down arrow to select next to proceed. The next step is to enter the low flow cutoff value. The low flow cutoff value eliminates totalizer activity for low flow rates. Press the right arrow to edit. Set your low flow cutoff value using the up and down arrows. Once you have input your low flow cutoff value, press the right arrow until OK is highlighted, and press the right arrow again to enter your selection. Press the down arrow to select next to proceed. You have successfully configured the measurement point 1. If this is a dual point unit, you can configure the next point using the right arrow to select yes. If this is your only point of measurement, then finish the configuration using the down arrow to select no. You are almost done. If you need to make any changes, use the up arrow to select back to scroll through the wizard to ensure the information is correct. If you want to start over again, press the left arrow to select cancel. If you are confident that you have entered all the correct data, then load and save the values into the sensor using the down arrow to select finish. Congratulations, you have completed the Flow Quick Start Wizard. When the wizard is complete, you will be brought back to the Wizard Quick Start selection. To exit the wizard and return to the main menu, press the left arrow. To exit the main menu and return to run mode, press the left arrow again. Once you are back in run mode, the device will start to indicate the flow measurement and you have successfully completed the Flow Quick Start Wizard. Congratulations! For more information, please visit our website.